Welcome back to Upper Michigan Today. It is time for us to make our garden salsa. A dream come true for Tia.
Oh man, I've been waiting all summer for this. Mm-hmm. And actually I've been waiting all year to plant the salsa garden in the first place so that I could make this. So,
it's a big deal for you.
It's a big deal. We even got cutting boards now, some mixing bowls. So I guess I'll just start by sharing my recipe,
okay, so I
have these numbers up there, like one white onion, four tomatoes, one jalapeno, one lime. I don't, you know, measure every single time. It's a rough estimate. I kind of just go based on what it looks like. You know, when I'm mixing it, if I think that has way too many jalapenos in it, then I will put more tomatoes or, you know, take something out. But that's the rough recipe. And, you know, it does not have to be an exact science because it's fairly simple.
And, you know, one of the things I love about salsa is it is simple. You don't have to overly complicate it.
You don't have to cook anything.
No,
either. You just gotta chop a couple of things.
You can just keep it real simple. Okay, so we are gonna just spend a segment chopping, right?
We're gonna just spend a segment chopping. So what do you want to chop?
Tell me. This is your salsa. What are you gonna put me in charge of?
I'll do the tomatoes. If you want to do the onion.
Yeah, I do.
Okay.
Okay.
Here you go.
Okay.
We have a new
knife. My goodness. Look at this. Look at this. Courtesy Robert Rosiak.
I love it.
Knife. Okay,
that's me.
The whole thing? Am I doing the whole thing?
We're doing the whole thing.
Okay. All right. And you like a white onion?
A white onion, yep. Some people prefer a red onion in their salsa and their pico, but I always prefer a white onion if I'm eating raw onion.
Oh.
I just think it has the best flavor.
Yeah. Oh, my eye is twitching. Somehow onion cutting all of a sudden made my eye twitch.
Man, my eyes water really bad when I cut onions.
You know what? Mine don't because I have contacts.
Okay.
It's like a shield to keep from
going too crazy. I'm so bad at cutting onions, so that's why I had you do it.
Well,
I'm really bad at dicing, I'm not gonna lie. It's a kitchen skill that I've not yet mastered.
You know what they make now? I don't know if any of you have this at home, but I bought one for my daughter and I have yet to buy one for myself, but it's a dicer.
And I used one at my mom's the other day.
Yes, you can make all different sizes of dicing, you know, or different like squares or whatever. She uses it actually like every day and I don't know why I don't just hurry up and buy myself one because I really need it. But it's one of those things like I would just buy it for someone else before. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Right, but then I think about it for myself. I'm like, man, I don't need that.
Exactly.
I could dice on my
exactly.
own. Oh my gosh, this is tough with this paring knife.
I'm almost done with this. I want to switch over.
Yeah, I do.
How many is this going to serve, you think? One.
Gosh, me. Just me.
Just Tia.
And a friend, maybe. Probably four.
Do you ever put mozzarella in your salsa?
No, I don't.
I just feel like that, like little chunks of mozzarella in here would be so good.
Does sound good.
But I'm really a mozzarella lover. You love mozzarella too.
I love mozzarella too.
Okay. Is this enough, you think?
Then I can give you that. Oh, that looks fantastic.
Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
And then I'll trade you a pair of knife.
Okay.
And you can cut up the jalapenos in little dices.
Oh, you're giving me the tough jobs. You're not messing around. Now, am I keeping the seeds or taking the seeds out?
It depends if you want it spicy or not. I like some seeds.
Okay. Okay. So leave them.
Leave them.
Do you want to switch knives?
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
Okay. All right. So I'm leaving the seeds. Remember when Jennifer? What did Jennifer make for us? She made
mango salsa.
Mango salsa. She left all the seeds of all the peppers in. I've never done that before. It was so good.
But
it was spicy. You do?
Yeah.
I usually don't. Okay.
And this is also really good to have with queso. I don't make my own queso. I prefer Border Girls queso. It's my favorite. And you can get it at the store now. And so my favorite thing is to heat up the queso and then to put a scoop of pico on top of it, just freshen up, lighten up the queso a little bit, or have it on nachos.
I always have Border Girl salsa or queso in my fridge now. I don't always have Border salsa in my fridge because we can't keep it long enough.
Yeah.
Like I buy it and it's immediately gone. It is really nice to have.
I'm struggling. This tomato is a juicer.
Uh-oh.
It's a little tough to chop. And my sleeves, too. I picked a bad sleeves for this.
I was thinking that, too. This jacket is kind of giant.
Alrighty, well.
But we're going to be fine.
We'll be just fine.
Okay.
Should we take a commercial break, keep chopping, and then when we come back, it should honestly probably be done. We could give it a try.
Okay.
Let's do it.
Okay. We'll be right back, you guys. I feel like we're concentrating so hard.
Like it got so quiet. We're talking about Sigma, and then all of a sudden we get serious.